Praise the Lord. Kingdom greetings and grace and peace to each and every one of you. With love from God our Father, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is Prophetess Nehemiah McLean here with Kingdom Global Impact Network, whereby we preach the unadulterated and fireable word of God, legislating God's kingdom right here on earth. Listen, I want to preach a powerful yet short and profound message to you. Are you publicly winning but privately losing? Yes, there are a lot of leaders that are hiding behind a mask of pain and they are battling in private. In fact, leaders are the ones that deal with the most warfare. They're the ones that have to preach to you while they are dealing with being ostracized, criticized, ridiculed, going through trauma, going through pain, dealing with being betrayed by sheep, being betrayed by friends and leaders. Amen. And oftentimes we are the ones, amen, that have no place to retreat to. Leaders, amen, have to minister to you when they want to cry. They have to minister to you when they are the ones that are bleeding. They are the ones that have to smile, amen, when really we are the ones that are dealing with the most pain. I want you to understand that no longer does God want you to have to deal with the private warfare. He wants you to begin to give your pain and your problems unto him. The Bible also reminds us, it says that yes, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver you out of them all. You don't have to fight the battle alone. In fact, you don't have to fight the battle at all. The Bible says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. There are many of you that want to give up and throw in the towel, but I want to remind you today, no retreat and no surrender, that you are going to get through this. Amen. Hallelujah. And you're going to get through this battle victorious. Oftentimes people are looking at us because they see the dazzling, they see the light, they see the title and the accolades, but they don't understand the warfare that you had to go through, what you had to experience in your life to get where you are. Yes, you had to deal with the scars before you had to see the stage. You had to deal with the turmoil before you got the title. You had to deal with the warfare before you can start to win. But in the mighty name of Jesus, I want to remind all the leaders that are watching this live broadcasting today to let you know that you are now breaking free from out of every bondage, every pain, every limitation, every pain of the past, and you are now plowing your way through, hallelujah, a place that's called Jubilee. You are gonna begin to experience what we call a bold paradigm breakthrough. Get ready, my friends, hallelujah, because you are about to experience a winning season, a season, amen, that you have never seen before. The Bible says, eyes have not seen, neither ears have heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man, the things that God has prepared for you. According to Jeremiah 29:11, it says, hallelujah, I know the thoughts that I think towards you, thoughts of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. So be encouraged, my friend. I know that oftentimes preaching, amen, may not seem easy. You have to preach your way through pain. But anytime you are feeling pain, I want you to understand that you are now experiencing a birthing season. Glory be to God, your birthing canal is about to open. Hallelujah, your birthing canal, amen, is opening. Hallelujah, and to see greater things in your life. There's great things that God has in store for you, but no leader, amen, is exempt from pain. Pain, amen, often leads you to your promise. Pain leads you to your prophecy. You are now giving birth. Hallelujah, you're giving birth to your prophecy. You're about to experience the greatest season of your life. Hold on a little while longer. Yes, you may have been down and out. You may have been in the valley low. You may have been in the miry clay. You might have felt like you were drowning and there was no way out. But I'm telling you today, to God be the glory, and I want to encourage every leader today, you have to deal with the fragmentation and the pain of your past, but don't look back. You're not going that way. You're thrusting and propelling into a new season of your life. According to Isaiah 43:19, it says, behold, I shall do a new thing, and now shall it spring forth. Shall you not know it? I know, amen, you may not see the light at the ending of the tunnel, but when you get there, I'm telling you, it's going to be joy unspeakable and full of glory. God is going to cause you to your years to be restored unto you. As it says in Joel chapter 2, it says that reformation and restoration shall come unto you. You are going to receive your recompense and back payment for every tear that you have cried. You're about to receive receive, hallelujah, your double portion for every pain that you have experienced. I want you to understand that God is about to give you your due diligence for everything that you have experienced in your life. Get ready, because God is about to bless you exponentially. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Amen. Yes, you are publicly leading, but privately losing. But now God is about to turn the tables. We're going to be winning all together in the mighty name of Jesus. No, you don't have to wear that mask any longer. You don't have to wear that mask of superficiality. But now that you are have gone through what you have gone through, you're coming out of this greater, you're coming out of this stronger and yet more powerful. Your testimony is about to turn into a praise party. Get ready to testify. Amen. And to God be the glory. Listen, my name is Prophetess Nehema McLean. You can find me on YouTube under the name Prophetess Nehema McLean. And also follow me on Facebook, Nehema McLean Ministries. God bless you, my friends. I love you. Jesus Christ love you. Live in the expectancy of God. The kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent taken by force. We're here to legislate the kingdom. Amen. And we are going to win under the power of the Holy Spirit. And I'm telling you right now that your destiny is not up for negotiation. God bless you, and shalom.